State government has revealed its rescue plan for the Latrobe Valley, set to be hit hard by the carbon tax. But it's relying on at least $200 million from the federal government, and that funding isn't guaranteed.
As he was given a view of the Latrobe Valley in a Gippsland-made plane, Acting Premier Peter Ryan denied he was on a flight of fancy as he spelled out the dangers of the carbon tax.
The Latrobe region is going to be impacted by the imposition of the carbon tax far worse than any other location in the Australian nation.
The government, wanting to be seen as the white knight for the brown coal-dominated area, unveiled a new $15 million rescue plan outlining the future of Gippsland post-carbon tax. Workers like Ben Lee welcoming the vision.
Which could put the valley back on the map for good reasons.
The plan encourages investment in areas other than power generation and mining, provides grants for clean coal technology and support for small businesses. But with the Commonwealth yet to agree to funding, so far it's just words on paper.
The $200 million they have in the compensation transition package, I don't think is going to be anywhere near enough money.
The transition to in the Latrobe Valley is not about a single document.
But as negotiations for the closure of part of the Hazelwood Power Station continue to drag on, many in the Latrobe Valley say a decision needs to be made soon to give the region some certainty.
Until we know the results of those negotiations, we can't move to the next step.
Workers hoping the plan amounts to more than just hot air. David Woywood, 10 News.